God said, "Let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth." So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them.
Without a vision from the Most High, the people perish. Everything seems impossible when you examine our current situations as a people. If you keep your eyes on the Most High, you will never lose sight of the vision He has for you and His people collectively.
Where there is no vision, the people perish. But he that keepeth the law, happy is he.
Israelites, the thoughts the Most High has towards us is to do us good, and it is to elevate us as a people. Yah did not create us to live independent from Him. You cannot live a fulfilling life independently of the Most High. We are at the bottom and mistreated because our ancestors forsaken our Elohim. This generation continue the rebellion. Because we have forsaken our Elohim, everything seems to be impossible to accomplish. The scriptures reveal to us that what is impossible for men is possible with the Most High.
But Jesus beheld them and said unto them, "With men this is impossible, but with God all things are possible."
Israelites, never mistake in our current position to be permanent. When we stop rebelling, then we will see the Most High sovereignty. The Israelites who keep their eyes on negativity will not prosper. You cannot make a difference if you are afraid to take a step. It is time, Israelites, you start to recognize when Satan is attacking you. In addition, you must know how to counter the attack. When you accept a lie for the truth, that is deception. If you believe the heathen's system is our source of survival, in addition, if you believe because we are in captivity, we cannot prosper, you have been deceived. The indigenous population that dwell in the most remote places on this earth are surviving outside of the heathen system. For a long time, we have been fighting without the Most High. In addition, we have been praying to idols. Now that we have the knowledge to overcome the kingdom of darkness, we have to use the wisdom. Use the knowledge gained to increase. Do not use the wisdom received by the Most High to decrease and to follow the heathens. The scripture said we could do all things in Yah who strengthens us.
I can do all things through Christ, which strengtheneth me.
To the Israelites who let the kingdom of darkness insert negativity into your minds, I hope the scriptures you have just heard will strengthen your spirits. Without the Most High, we cannot do anything because the Most High made His creation depend on Him. If Yah be for us, regardless to how our enemies perceive our outward conditions, we can do anything. Remember, Israelites, the Most High said not to focus on the seen things. The heathens make it seem as if we need them. We do not need them. They need us. I will repeat, the hybrids need us. Without us, they would perish. In order for the hybrids to increase their population, they have to breed with an indigenous person. Once they procreate with an indigenous person, they influence the offspring, the half-caste, to mate with a hybrid. What the biracial and a hybrid procreate is not indigenous. The offspring is a full-blooded hybrid by the fourth generation. In the society we live in, they seduce the half-caste to procreate with a hybrid to strengthen their seed. The truth is they are weakening their seed. The kingdom of darkness and its human agents must use deception to get you to go along with their agenda. Israelites, I hope you can see why it is important to the heathens to make sure the world hates the dark skin. By hating dark skin, the half-caste will gravitate to mate with the people that is considered superior. That is how they increase their population. The hybrids cannot afford not to procreate with the original people. If they do not, they will die out. This is why you see an emphasis on interracial dating. The way the kingdom of darkness succeed in building its army, Satan uses human agents to carry out his plans. The half-castes give birth to your future oppressors. The workers of iniquity cast spells on the weak of our people to separate the original man and woman. By making the original man and woman enemies, the original man and woman will procreate with the hybrids to increase the hybrids' population. The hybrids have infiltrated every so-called race. Only the Israelites who are vibrating on high frequency can understand what I am saying. Those who operate on low vibrations will react the same way the world reacts to people who do not support and go along with their popular opinions. Israelites, you are the ones keeping the heathen system operating. You are marrying the heathens, creating offsprings with them, diluting your bloodline. You are the one working at the satanic corporations and spending your money at the satanic establishments. Many Israelites do not support their people. They are divided. While you are building up the heathens' nations and strengthening their economy, you remain a slave at the bottom in the heathen system. Since you are the one making the heathen system prosper, you have to make the decision to stop supporting their system. You have to choose this day who you're going to serve.
And if it seem evil unto you to serve the Lord, choose you this day whom ye will serve, whether the gods which your fathers served that were on the other side of the flood, or the gods of the Amorites, in whose land ye dwell. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. And the people said unto Joshua, Nay, but we will serve the Lord. And Joshua said unto the people, Ye are witnesses against yourselves that ye have chosen you, the Lord, to serve him. And they said, We are witnesses.
If you choose to serve the Elohim of Israel, then cast down the wicked imaginations that rise up against the word of Yah, just as the Most High instruct you to do. Follow the instructions of the Most High. Obey the voice of Yah. The scriptures inform you that when you truly serve the Most High with all of your heart and soul, he will reverse your captivity. The prophet Daniel spoke about this information age. In the last days, knowledge would increase. People would run to the scriptures.
But thou, O Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book, even to the time of the end. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall be increased.
Israelites, now is the time to make a difference. Use the knowledge gained to further your deliverance. Use the spirit of truth to petition the Most High to save his people.
Likewise, the spirit also helpeth our infirmities. For we know not what we should pray for as we ought. But the spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. And he that searcheth the hearts knoweth what is the mind of the Spirit, because he maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God. And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to his purpose.
The heathen's system depend on you and the resources in your nations to thrive. This is why it was important to the kingdom of darkness to plant tares all over the world. Colonization gave the hybrids control of land that do not belong to them. The kingdom of darkness have ignored the way the Most High distribute the earth to his creation. Also replace the laws of the Most High with man-made laws. You cannot depend on their court system to try your case fairly. The odds will always be against you. The heathens have convinced Israelites who live in superpower nations that third world countries are poor and are places they do not want to live. Yet the people who live in the so-called third world countries for thousands of years are surviving. The propaganda mainstream media flood the news with images of people in third world countries that are malnourished, sick, and homeless. Satan's media pollute your mind with images to stop you from visiting, in addition to become more dependent on their system. If you become dependent on the heathen system, you will not abandon the lifestyle that you have grown accustomed to. Third world countries are not poor, Israelites. I will repeat, they are not poor. The hybrids are oppressing these people through colonization. In addition, the people do not have control over their lands due to corruption by wicked governments installed by wicked heathens. The people who live in third world countries are making the designer clothes you spend thousands of dollars on. Where do the workers from third world countries find the resources to make the clothes? Third world nations have a vast amount of natural resources to provide for the people who live on the land. The people in the third world nations live like our ancestors. They live off what the land produces. They do not have big factories with heavy machinery for mass production. Unless the heathens build a factory to deceive the people into believing they are there to create jobs. Behind the scenes, they are stealing the natural resources from that nation. If a person in a third world nation do not plant food, harvest the crops, raise livestock by using the skills the Most High placed in them, then they have to depend on the kingdom of darkness to provide for them. The indigenous people do not have to depend on the government system to survive. This is how the Most High intended for us to live. The Most High made sure that He created rain to water the earth so that the crops can grow, to feed His people and the animals. If you dig deep into the soil, you will find clean water to drink. If Abraham, who was rich in cattle, survived like this, why can't we find the same success?
And Abraham was very rich in cattle, in silver, and in gold.
The kingdom of darkness made you believe the third world country's lifestyle is poor. The truth is the people who live in these nations are healthier than those who live off the heathen system. The people in third world countries eat real food. They are active. They have the knowledge to take care of the land the Most High gave to their ancestors for inheritance. They have the natural skills to survive of what the land produces. They are not plagued with diseases. When the hybrids visit third world countries like the tourists they are, the heathens bring their diseases and the indigenous populations start to die. The native Indians in the Americas, majority of them died when the paleface brought their diseases with them. The propaganda media want you to believe the heathen system is the best thing that has happened to the indigenous population. They have deceived many into believing that because they have running water in their house, that is an accomplishment. Some people in third world nations have running water in their house like any superpower nations, while some have to fetch water. The advantage the people in the so-called third world nations have over the people in superpower nations, they are drinking clean, pure water. They're not drinking water with chemicals. If you drink the tap water in your house, you would be sick. The water is laced with all kinds of chemicals. Many people spend a lot of money purchasing bottled waters to drink. Even the bottled waters is full of chemicals. The food you eat in the heathen system is not real food. 99% of the food you eat is chemically engineered. Diseases such as cancer stems from the food. Many people die young because of their poor diet. America have an overwhelming population of obese people. The food the USDA deem edible is not good for you. In addition, the GMO food is not breaking down in your body, causing even more health issues. The healthcare system is a joke. The prescription drugs they give you to cure one problem add on many other problems. The Most High infused the world with natural medicine to clean your body and to cure any disease. Third world nations depend on natural medicine to cure their people. It is only when the so-called tourists of the world say they're going to help, all of a sudden there is an Ebola outbreak, then the people develop flu-like symptoms. In the heathen system, you never own anything. You work to pay debt. The debt is endless. You work to build your enemies' corporations. You work to keep your enemies in power so that they can continue to oppress you. You believe the many conveniences or amenities the superpower nations have to offer are above the third world nations. The truth is that is not accurate. The heathen system depends on third world nations' resources to keep their economy booming. This is why they have to oppress other nations to maintain their dominance. If the nations in Africa create their own currency backed with the diamonds, gold, oil, and other precious metals, nobody could stand against them. This is why they killed Gaddafi. He was trying to make that happen. Third world nations have plenty of gold and precious metals. The heathen superpower nations do not. If you take the time to analyze the heathen system, it is far worse than any third world nation. How does their diabolical system benefit you, Israelites? If their system do not benefit you, it would make sense to disconnect from their system. Israelites, you do not need their system. You have to learn to ask your Father, the Elohim of Israel, to provide for you. The scripture said if you ask for anything in prayer, and if you believe, you will receive.
And all things whatsoever ye shall ask in prayer, believing, ye shall receive.
Israelites have been connected to the heathen system far too long. Most Israelites do not recognize their deliverance. The Most High is making this information available to you to deliver you. This information is not meant for you to hang on to the heathen system with one hand and the Most High with the other hand. You cannot serve two masters. Third world nations have wealthy people as well as poor people. The heathen system have poor people as well as wealthy people. The heathen system is not better than the third world nations. The Most High did not create us to be in front of a computer desk 80 hours a week in a factory slaving for the heathens. We are the people of the sun. We have to be outside with fresh air. Could you imagine the hybrids out in the sun working hard labor, picking cotton in the sun? The sun would burn them to death. That is why they needed you. Israelites, it is important to the kingdom of darkness to discourage you from separating from the heathens to build your own communities and nations. If you truly separate from the heathens, who will be their slaves? Who will work to keep their corporations at float? Who will do the jobs they do not want to do? Who will run their corporations while they are on vacations? Who will boost their economy to make them remain a superpower nation? Unfortunately, we are a people that is plundered and our resources is up for grabs.
But this is a people robbed and spoiled. They are, all of them, snared in holes, and they are hid in prison houses. They are for a prey, and none delivereth, for a spoil, and none saith, restore.
This is why you see the heathens in our communities robbing us. If we are not doing anything with the resources in our communities, our enemies will gladly take our resources to build themselves up. If there is a black exit, like the United Kingdom exit the European Union, the superpower nations of this world will not stand. The only reason they are standing, the times of the heathens are not yet fulfilled, and the Most High needs to protect the remnant of His people living in those nations. If we were not in every nation, the Most High would have destroyed them a long time ago.
But the day of the Lord is near upon all the heathen. As thou hast done, it shall be done unto thee. Thy reward shall return upon thine own head. For as ye have drunk upon my holy mountain, so shall all the heathen drink continually. Yea, they shall drink, and they shall swallow down, and they shall be as though they had not been. But upon Mount Zion shall be deliverance, and there shall be holiness, and the house of Jacob shall possess their possessions.
Most Israelites do not realize the Most High command us to take care of this earth and to rule over everything.
And God blessed them, and God said unto them, Be fruitful, and multiply, and replenish the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth.
When the Most High issue a command, He is telling us to do it. If you do not do it, He will hold you accountable. A command is not a choice. It is your responsibility as Yah's creation to take care of the earth. Stop handing over your duties to the heathens and the kingdom of darkness. The heathens and the kingdom of darkness is destroying the earth. Israelites, you have to reconnect with the Most High. As a nation, we can no longer fight independently of the Most High. The heathen system is making a mockery out of you. How can the Most High deliver you if you do not know you need deliverance? You cannot depend on the very system oppressing your life to deliver you, nor to take good care of you. The heathen system pollute the air you breathe in with chemicals. How can anyone accept the heathen system over what the Most High has for you? Do not believe the heathens when they say to you third world nations are poor. That is false. Africa is the richest continent on earth. The heathens have colonized the continent of Africa to claim ownership of its resources. The kingdom of darkness has placed the heathen system on a pedestal, while the lands around the world that is infused with natural resources is considered impoverished. Third world countries have precious metals, stones the heathens and pogrom Israelites fetishize. Why are the precious metals and stones worthless in third world nations, but in the heathen system it's worth trillions of dollars? The mental captivity the kingdom of darkness has placed on the indigenous population has destroyed them. Israelites, now that you have the knowledge of how the kingdom of darkness made you depend on their system instead of the Most High, now is the time to make that transition. If we are to serve the Most High in the spirit and in truth, we have to serve with all of our hearts and mind. We cannot choose which area we want to serve the Most High. The heathens have no problem submitting and serving their idols. We should display the same enthusiasm for our Elohim. Now is the time to practice what you preach. If you love the Most High and want to serve Him in the spirit and in the truth, you have to back what you're saying with actions. Faith without works is dead.
Even so, faith, if it hath not works, is dead.
If we truly want change, we have to do our part and take the necessary steps. Then the Most High can order our steps. The scriptures made it clear that when we turn from our wicked ways, repent, seek, and take heed to the Most High's instructions, then Yah will reverse our captivity. We can no longer go against the will of the Most High. We have to collaborate with Yah to find deliverance. Israelites, if you learn how to defeat your enemies in the spirit realm, I guarantee there will be a shift in the physical realm. Do not only focus on the physical realm. The spirit realm is where it matters. Defeat your enemies in the spirit realm. Watch how they will become your footstool in the physical realm. Do not overthink the battle. Focus on the right target. A time will come when Israelites everywhere will declare, enough is enough. I am glad that the Most High reassured me that a day is coming when the remnant of His people will return to serve Him. Israelites, make sure you are part of that remnant.
At the same time, saith the Lord, will I be the God of all the families of Israel, and they shall be my people. Thus saith the Lord, the people which were left of the sword found grace in the wilderness, even Israel, when I went to cause him to rest. The Lord hath appeared of old unto me, saying, yea, I have loved thee with an everlasting love. Therefore with loving kindness have I drawn thee. Again I will build thee, and thou shalt be built, O Virgin of Israel. Thou shalt again be adorned with thy tabrets, and shalt go forth in the dances of them that make merry.